Good morning, and it's a new day. Again, it's always a new day. Today, I'm gonna be continuing to cut to get the sides on this so I can get it to the skeletal frame. Not gonna go into detail, I've done that in past videos. So I'll just go ahead and we'll get started.
Might be something here, but a chain box is pretty big. I was thinking about leaving the site. We'll be right back.
it is. But I've been selling these dirts from way back in its heyday. And this was a brand new, and this was a newer unit. Get some fresh paint on here. None of that's attached. I might be able to cut that out. A lot of dirt and crap that you have to put down in there. Adds extra weight to the truck, I guess. Maybe that was the plan. I could have taken, you know, somebody probably asked, why should you just take the grinder to it? That's not as much fun. No, actually, the reason is sometimes you don't have a grinder. Or the grinder might go down, and I want to know I have options. Let's see. Got some more inclement weather that's supposed to be coming in. Don't know how much accumulation we'll get, but I'm hoping we'll get a foot of snow, at least. Main part's supposed to hit Sunday. We'll see. Let's see if I can get the saw on that. That's just a small piece of angle iron. I'm only quick work of it. Maybe I should have used this one first though. I bust the PT. Cut it fast. Cut it like butter. Again, and as always, it's a new day. So got a bit done yesterday, and so I've got both sides cut off, or hips, fenders, however you want to call it. And you'll have to forgive the noise, or the sound is pretty noisy in here, running the plasma cutter and or the plasma torch, the compressor, and all that. So to try and make it, you know, so you could at least hear my voice, the editing is kind of funky. So please forgive me for that, but continue watching. Today's plan is to take and to continue to strip down the rest of the plating that is on this so that I, like I said, I want to try and get down to this bare frame here. I'm going to cut all this out in here, at least to here. And the reason for that is because I, like I said before, I want to make it so I have accessibility to all the hoses and connections. And then I can inspect all the hoses and make sure that they're all still good, that I don't need to replace any. And if I do, then it's not so hard to replace. So I will get that all cutting. I'm gonna be cutting this piece off and all this through here, any excess stuff. I'm gonna be cutting all that off, be cutting off this old wiring junction box. And then I'm gonna go through with the wire wheel and clean it all up. And don't know how much of this I'll get done today, but I will try to get as much done as possible. And then one of the things I need to do is I'm gonna take, I'll grind all this, cut this all off, clean it all up. And then after it's mounted onto the truck, then I will probably take and order new bushings and start replacing bushings, making sure everything's able to get greased okay. So that is today's plan. We'll see how much of it I can get done. And we'll go to work. There might be a lot of just no sound music, and because, again, it's going to be pretty noisy, so I don't want you guys to sit there and get your ears blown out with a bunch of noise, so probably deaden the noise and just have some background music going. This is the sawzall that I used yesterday, so we're going to go ahead and use it again. We'll be right back. updates. Well, that's definitely taking it off. That's when you know you've used all your blade. basically, what I'm getting at is, what will be nice is, when this is all put together, if I blow a hose or something like that, all the plating that I've got bolted on, I'll be able to get to all this stuff. Everything. From up top, instead of crawling around in the mud and the dirt and everything like that, to fix a part on the truck. So, definitely needs to go see a pressure washer. She sure will. I have one. And I'll degrease the crap out of it, pressure wash the crap out of it. So, lots of hoses, lots of lines, but it'll be very, very nice. Easy to get to everything. So, I may cut this and raise it. Or do it in such a way. But you see how these things are built. You know, no one's really ever got to see how people actually, how the factory actually builds these things. Kind of cool. This is the control valve. Here, I think this is the electronic controls for the electronics. And then this is the manual controls. We're gonna find out. And I may take and move the valve body in a different spot, who knows? It's hard to say, now that I'll have more access to it. Change out that hydraulic filter and clean all that up. But yeah, that's how she's going to go. If you like this video, give a thumbs up and like and subscribe. Tell your friends, share, and I'll try to get these videos out there. I know there's a lot of people that like this. I hope you guys like it. This is kind of the project I'm working on now. It looks like we're gonna get some pretty good snow. I'm looking out the door here and it's snowing pretty good, and I hope it accumulates to something. If it does accumulate to something, then then very cool. If it doesn't, then not so cool. So that's all I got for now. Something came up. It's kind of time sensitive, so I gotta take care of that. But you know, I've got more videos. I've got one right there, and I've got another one right there.